Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise number 1.7 of our textbook, first course in probability. So in this problem, the goal is to look at the total number of possible ceilings in a row of three boys and three girls. So in the first question, there is no restriction, but then in question B, C, and D, we are going to have some restriction on the possible ceilings. So these are examples of permutation. If you go back to the first video of this playlist about the continuous rules, you will see that it's these are examples of permutation. So in the first question, that's basic permutation, but then after things become a little bit more complicated due to those restrictions. And I'm going to show you tricks to do the counting. So here we have three boys and three girls, and they must sit in a row like this of size 6. You have 6 chairs. And so in the first question, you have no restriction on the seating. Of course, we assume that boys and girls are distinguishable. You have 3 different boys, 3 different girls. We are not dealing with blocks with same or different colors. We are dealing with individuals, so those individuals are distinguishable. And so that means that you have 6 possibilities for the first chair, for the first seat, then 5 for the second one, then 4, 3, 2, 1. So that's a basic example of permutation. In this case, the total number of seating is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that simplifies, and you can write this as 6 factorial. That's a basic example of permutation without repetition. And if you compute that number, you would find 720. Now, going back to the slide. So the second question is the same, but now we have one restriction, which is that the 3 boys must be together and the 3 girls must be together. So in this case, boys together, girls together. So one possible way to proceed is exactly like we did to find this 6 factorial. It's to proceed sequentially by looking at the number of possibilities for the first seat and then multiply by the number of possibilities for the second seat and so on. In this case, that would give you, because you have 6 individuals, you can start with one of the 6. You have 6 possibilities for the first seat. But then, because boys must be together and girls must be together, for the second seat, if you chose a boy at the first place, you need again a boy for the second seat. If you choose a girl at the first place, you need a girl for the second seat. So that would give you a 6 × 2 × 1. And then you start with the other group, and then 3, 2, 1. Except that this reasoning, like counting things sequentially, works in this case only because we have 2 groups of the same size. Now, if you have to deal with more groups, or more importantly, if you have groups that are not of the same size, then this reasoning is not going to work. If I had 3 boys, 4 girls, then that's not a correct way to count things. In fact, things are more difficult than that. And so I'm going to show you a trick to find the number of possible seatings in this case. So what you do is that you write your individual. So let's call them B1, B2, B3 for the 3 boys, G1, G2, G3 for the 3 girls. Then you are going to write your condition using rectangles, like exhibiting groups. So the condition is that the 3 boys must be together and the 3 girls must be together. So that means that you have 2 groups of size 3. And the way you count the number of possible seatings in this case is by saying that first we are going to order the groups. Because you have 2 groups, you have 2 factorial ways to order those groups. 2 factorial is 2, so that means you start with all boys, then all girls, or the other way around, all girls and then all boys. So you have 2 factorial equals 2 possible ways to order those 2 groups, okay? And then you still need to order the 3 boys in their group and the 3 years in their group. And so that gives you a 3 factorial for this group and 3 factorial for this group. Okay, so then 3 factorial times 3 factorial. Okay, and this turns out to be equal to 72. So you have 72 possible seedings of girls and boys in the row, in such a way that the boys are together and the girls are together. So keep in mind that in general, what you want to do if you want to have groups that sit really together, it's to first look at those blocks where you have, and you can have more than 2 groups, you can have 3, 4, 5 groups and so on. And step one, you order the groups. And step two, you are going to order each element within each group. So that's the correct way of counting. That's that makes things much easier to think that way. Okay, so now let's look at the third question. And the third question is again an example of such a permutation. So in this case, the boys must be together, but the girls don't have to be together. And so that's exactly the same reasoning as question B, except that this time, instead of having a group of 3 boys and a group of 3 girls, you are going to have a group of 3 boys and 3 groups with a single girl. Okay, so you start again by writing your individuals, B3, then G1, G2, G3. Now the groups become the following. You have groups like that. So that kind of shows the condition you want. Those 3 girls don't have to be together. They form like independent groups. But then those 3 boys must be together, and so they are within the same group. So you see that in this case, following the same reasoning as before, what we do first is order those groups. Now, instead of a 2 factorial, you are going to have a 4 factorial because you have 4 groups. But then you need to multiply by a product of 4 terms corresponding to the number of possible permutations of elements in each group. For the boy group, you are going to have 3 factorial possible permutations of the boys in their group. And then for the girls, you just have 1 factorial times 1 factorial times 1 factorial. 1 factorial is equal to 1, so you can ignore this part. And so eventually that tells you that the answer should be, so you start with a 4 factorial, that's the number of ways you can order those 4 groups, and then 3 factorial. That's the number of ways you can order the 3 boys in their group. And then again, 1 factorial times 1 factorial times 1 factorial, that's just equal to 1. And eventually, if you compute this number explicitly, you would find 144. So exactly twice that number. And so that answers the third question. Now, fourth question. In the fourth question, now we assume that we cannot have 2 boys next to each other and we cannot have 2 girls next to each other. So in this case, again, if you do the counting sequentially by looking at the number of possibilities for each sheet and for each sheet, like one by one, you might be in trouble. In general, in this case that works well, but in general things can be complicated. So here, what we are going to do first is ignore individuals and just look at their genders. Okay, we are only going to assume that we are going to first assume that the 3 boys are identical elements and the 3 girls are identical elements. Look at the number of ways you can order those elements in a row of length 6 in such a way that no 2 elements of the same type or of the same color are next to each other. And then you still, again, exactly like for the blocks like that, you still need to order individual within each group. So in this case, you start with, I mean, you have a row like that. So if the first seat is occupied by a boy, okay, and now you see I'm not writing B1, B2, B3, I'm just writing B for boy. I don't care which boy is at the first place, I just write boy. Then if you start with a boy, the restriction tells us that then you need a girl, then again a boy, then a girl, then a boy, then a girl. That's one possibility. Second possibility, if you start with a girl, then you need boy, girl, boy, girl, boy. So that gives you indeed two possibilities, and you see that if you fix the gender of the first person in the row, then the rest of the row is fixed in terms of gender. Okay, so that gives you two possibilities. So to count the number of possible permutations of the boys and girls in this case, you start with two, so that corresponds to those two possibilities. Then, once you fix one of the two options, so let's say the second one, you still need to decide of those three girls, which one is going to be girl one, which one is going to be girl two, which one is going to be girl number three, and that gives you, again, three factorial possible permutations, exactly like we found here. And same for the boys, there are three boys, you have three seats for the three boys, but you still need to look at all possible permutations of the boys on those three specific seats. That gives you, again, three factorial possibilities. And so the answer is 2 × 3 × 3. And you see that 2 × 2, so you get exactly the same answer as in question B. And that gives you a 72. So, conclusion, the total number of ways those boys and girls can sit in a row such that no two boys are next to each other and no two girls are next to each other is equal to 72.